playing great. He's an all-star.
You know, a very competitive goaltender.
And this year's winner of the 2020 Vezina is?
I fell in love with it. I first started in roller hockey, but I fell in love with it just because my family is always into hockey, and we all got together and play Hellebuyck's hockey once a year. And
early on, they played a roller. His brother was 5 and he could play. Connor had to wait. And so Connor sat on the sidelines and he told me, "Dad, I want to play when I'm 5, but I want to be a goalie." Early on, there was this point. He was about 10 years old, and we were in between games at a tournament, and I found him in the pro shop. And this is back when there's 2-piece sticks, you know, blades separate from the shaft. And he's in there looking at all the blades. And I walked up and I said, "Why are you looking at player blades? Why aren't you looking at the goalie stuff?" And he turns around and he sticks a blade right in my face, and it's got this huge twist. He goes, "Dad, if someone shoots on me with that stick, where do you, or that blade, where do you think the puck's going?" And I said, "Well, unless they screw up the shot, it's going high." And he goes, "Exactly." He says, "I want to memorize every one of these blades so I know where the puck's going when it's on the blade before they shoot it." Wow. And I just said, "I just, okay, kid, just go for it."
You know, I was having a good season and starting to get some calls from colleges, and UMass was the first team that came and looked and talked to me and
told the coaches, "Okay, I'm here to watch Connor, so you can let them know." And the next night, Connor played even better, which he said just impressed the heck out of me.
After the weekend, they offered me a full scholarship right away, and you know, I, being so new to it, didn't really know what's right, what's wrong, how to do that whole process. So I jumped on my first offer.
The first views I had on Helly were in college. We would get game film from them. Their college coaches or our scouting directors would pull up and I would watch his college games.
I wasn't at the draft and I wasn't on the central scouting, so I didn't really expect to get drafted. At that time, I was being a goalie coach for younger kids than myself, and so I was working, and I was sitting on the couch watching the draft, and all of a sudden my name popped up, and I was supposed to do a lesson, but I had someone else jump in my lesson for me because I had just tons of media phone calls to do and couldn't believe it.
And all of a sudden, our phones just exploded. Because, "Hey, congratulations." So, "Well, what? Connor just got drafted." It's like, "What?"
That was a crazy transition. You know, that it's the fun part and it's the hard part. This is where you learn to fail and how to succeed.
At times you'd watch him and he doesn't seem to ever have to make that highlight reel save, but what really was a learning curve was he doesn't have to make it because he's always so strong positionally, so.
He had a very solid foundation in his game, and to add to that is competitiveness. You know, very competitive goaltender, battles hard in practice.
You know, some goalies are destined to be backups, some goalies are destined to be starters, and really it comes down to, you know, the mental side of things, I think, in a lot of cases.
I'm here and get better every day and give my best. I know I'm playing the right way and I'm going to continue to play the right way. I'm going to continue striving forward and keep climbing that mountain that we're talking about here. I know myself better than anyone else knows myself, so when I said those things, I truly believed it. And if you don't believe in it, it can never happen.
Here's a chance out in front for Horvat in tight, but a shot goes stopped by Hellebuyck.
So, I mean, it was nice that it happened so fast to get that monkey off my back, per se, but you know, I truly believed that everything I was going to do was going to lead me down the right path to make that happen.
And Connor looked at me at his freshman year in high school and he said, "Dad, I don't have a backup plan." And I said, "That's okay. It takes time to figure out what you want." He goes, "No, I don't want a backup plan." He says, "It's just going to distract me. I'm just going to keep playing. I'm going to keep working until I make the NHL."